In this demonstration, I would like to show you how to create your pixel mappings using Stage Tool. As an example, we will be creating a pixel mapping for the main stage of Intense Festival back in 2014. This is the technical image that is provided to us. Here we can find all the information we need to make our pixel mapping. First of all, we need the name and resolutions of our in and output compositions. The name of our event will be Intense Festival. The area will be the main stage. For our input composition, we are going to use an HD resolution. So hit create. The name of our output composition, and we only have one, is going to be output number one. For the resolutions, we will use this resolution because this corresponds with the output resolution. So it will be 1280 by 1024. Now hit create. As you can see, it also creates an ID layer with the information of our output and also the resolution that is linked to your comp resolution. So if we change this, the text will automatically change with it. Also, the folders are created. These we will be needing to create our pixel mapping. We need to specify our target. This will be the target composition where our slices will be created. If the targets aren't listed, just refresh your targets and then choose one from the drop-down menu. Now we can create our first slice. To do so, we have a couple of options. The first option is your tile size. This is the resolution of each tile. Then we have the resolution of our slice, the position of our slice on the output composition, the name, the color, and if you want to apply your logo to the slice, enable this option. You can simply use your own logo by replacing the logo file in the images folder. With the negatives option, you will be able to remove specified tiles after you created your slice. Let's create the slice. First, we need the tile size. This will be 96 by 96. Then the slice resolution will be 672 by 672. The position of our slice will be 00. The slice is called 1. Let's give it a red color. Let's enable the logo for this slice. And as we can see here, we will need to remove some tiles from our slice. So let's also enable negatives. Let's create the slice. In case you are not happy with your slice, you can just undo the action. In case you need to delete it later, you can select your slice and hit the delete slice button. This will also delete any children of the slice. A virtual slice is a slice without any visual feedback. It will still take your tile size and resolution. Now we need to remove our corner tiles. We can do this by going to the negatives tab and specify which tiles we want to remove. With row, we can specify which row of our slice we want to remove our tiles in. With count, we can specify how many tiles we want to remove. With first, we can skip tiles. In this case, we want to remove the first tile of our first row. So hit create negative. Then we want to remove the first tile of our last row. This is row 7. With these buttons, we can mirror our remove tiles. This will mirror in the horizontal axis. This will mirror in the vertical axis. And this will remove any mirrors you have active on your tile. Now let's mirror our horizontal axis. As you can see, we have a perfect perfect matching slice. For the second and third slice, we are going to do the same. The tile size is 40 by 40. The resolution will be 360 by 360. The position of our second slice will be 800 by 0. Let's name our slice 2 and give it a green color. Let's disable the logo for our slice. And also, we need to remove some corner tiles here. So let's enable negatives and create our slice. Let's go to the negative step and specify which tiles we want to remove. In this case, we want to remove 2 tiles of our first row and 1 tile of our second row. Let's mirror that on the vertical axis and also mirror it on the horizontal axis. Now we have a perfect matching slice. Let's do this for the third slice. In this case, we only need to change the name and maybe the color of our slice. Let's name our slice 3 and give it a purple color. Also for this slice, we don't want the logo and have our negatives enabled. In this case, the position is 800 by 480. Don't forget to change that as well. In case you forget, you can simply reposition your slice. As you can see, the text indicators will be updated. Now let's remove our tiles. We want to remove the first 2 tiles of our first row and 1 tile of our second row. Let's mirror it in the vertical axis and in the horizontal axis. Now we have a perfect matching output composition. By default, the slices in the input composition will have the same position as the output composition. This is not what we want, because we want our input composition to represent the stage setup. So let's reposition our slices. If we want to make changes to our slices in a later stadium, we can do this with the custom parameters in the input composition. For example, we want to make our logo smaller, so let's decrease the size of our logo. We can also increase the size of our slice, rotate our slice, change the text box size, and recolor our slices. After we are done with our pixel map, we can export our files in the export tab. Here you can give your files a name, change the path, and export your XML for Resolume, a screenshot of your input composition, a screenshot of your output composition, and your mask. In case you need to mask one of your slices in Resolume, you can also do this in After Effects by dragging a rectangle mask over one of your slices. This mask will also be transported to Resolume. Let's load our pixel map into Resolume. As you can see, It also imported the mask. Thank you for watching this demo.